situation around them. So lot actually influence the sexual behavior of an aging man. Libido is a major target of androgen action in the male sexual function. Now what actually happens is, now there are various threshold of the level of androgen for various sexual activity. Libido needs, even at a lower testosterone, libido will be intact. Above that, so erection will need more than this testosterone. Now think about a person who is between these two. So there is a libido, but erection is not happening. And therefore, you find more clinical cases of erectile dysfunction. Think about one patient who is having both ED and low libido. He may not come for complaining. But he is okay. Got it? But somebody who is having libido intact and having ED, he is the one who will be coming for the medical intervention. So therefore, when you see the stat, you will find out ED cases are more. Actually, they are reported more. Got it? And for ED also, so whenever you are treating these people, you have to find out other reasons of ED other than testo deficiency. Because sometimes you just give, so patient is ED, here libido and patient level is here. You give them testo, everything goes good, libido is very very good, but his ED was having some other reason, mainly in diabetic patient. Now intense libido is there, but no erection is there. It is actually cruelty to the patient and the partner. This becomes a bigger problem. And similarly, other way around, patient has no issues, the partner had the issues. Partner had dyspareunia or whatever, some illnesses for which she cannot be sexually active, and the male partner is so much attached to his spouse that he doesn't want to, you know, trouble her or go anywhere else too. So what he is doing is, he has suppressed himself over a period of time so that they are adapted in a new environment. Now here, this partner, now because of all this, he will have some fatigue, lethargy also. Why not? Because testosterone is when dropping, other things will also happen. And arousal is arousal. So his arousal and other things will also go down. So in that scenario, if he goes to a doctor and the doctor test for his testosterone and find it low, a bit, I mean to say in the lower tertile, then he may give him testosterone, and this testosterone can actually give him arousal, libido, and which can become a problem because now his partner is not ready for that, and this gives guilt in both, and this can actually spoil the family. Something we tried for good, it destroyed the family. So therefore, history taking is very important, very very important. Give enough time, talk to them. Okay, why not? Ek pahiye mein ho jata.